This vintage original poster is from the 1920s and advertises Bernard Elving's Metropolitan Theater in Newark, New Jersey. The poster was in very poor condition and we put it through an extensive poster fix.
Another exciting day in the Posterfix shop. We are doing a very rare poster, one that we have never seen before and we will probably never see again. A few years ago, I had the honor and privilege of restoring a very rare poster in Hebrew characters advertising Elving's Metropolitan Theater in Newark, New Jersey. This was a theater that catered to the Jewish audience of Newark and the surrounding areas. And we got this beautiful, interesting poster in the shop to restore. So that's what you're going to see us do today at Posterfix.
To say this is fragile would be an understatement. I'm looking at it and I see there's rips in the fold lines. There's some missing area, like there, where we'll have to recreate parts of the image. And up here, look, a face is missing. We have to recreate a face. The letters won't be as hard, and there's staining in the paper. And once this is cleaned and linen-backed, we can go ahead and restore all that missing stuff. So that's what we're going to do now. I'm going to lay this down onto a piece of acid-free paper, which has already been mounted to the screen, which is stretched with cotton canvas. The poster is too fragile to apply the wheat paste directly to the poster, so instead I'm going to apply the wheat paste to the acid-free paper. This wheat paste is mixed with a fungicide added to it, as well as an acid buffer. That way it won't have mold forming or any other bacteria taking root in the poster. And the acid will be neutralized for a period of many decades, if not more. So there, the wheat paste is prepared, and now I'm applying it directly to the acid-free paper. Once the poster has been flipped over, it begins to absorb the wheat paste and expand. This paper is very thin and very dry, so it absorbs the wheat paste quite quickly. Newark, New Jersey was home to New Jersey's only successful Yiddish theater, Elving's Metropolitan Yiddish Theater, opened from 1921 to 1947. So this theater was run by Bernard Elving and his brother Israel Elving. Israel Elving was the manager of the theater and was responsible for promoting the theater and for having these posters made. The most effective way he could target potential audiences before each new show was with colorful window posters printed at the West Side printing house and placed in the windows of kosher butcher shops in Newark and in outlying communities in Passaic and Union counties with sizable Jewish populations. Each shopkeeper received two free passes to the show for displaying the poster in his window. A poster like this one. Bernard Elving was born in Poland. His father was the owner of a steam mill. And you can read about his life before he came to America and established this theater online. Now that I've sprayed the poster to help it expand, I need to move all of these pieces into their proper place. Make sure that the paper is stretched out to its maximum stretch. But it's extremely difficult to have this happen and to have all the letters and lines come up straight. It's a real trick because when the paper's wet, it sort of acts like gobbly, bendable rubber or something. And I've got to force it back into its straightness.
From 1922 to 1944, New York City's thriving Second Avenue Yiddish theater had its counterpart on a Newark Third Ward Street in the heart of the city's vibrant and thickly populated Jewish community. It was Elving's Metropolitan Theater at 117 Montgomery Street, corner of Charlton Street, just a block up from the Prince Street Jewish shopping mecca. The theater was built and operated by the Elving brothers, Bernard and Israel, both Polish-born and both veterans of the New York City Yiddish theater. Bernard was the lead actor in a majority of the plays, frequently playing opposite his wife, Rose, who not only acted but also co-wrote many of the plays with her husband. We're laying down Mylar on top of the poster so that I can take a roller and roll out the poster. That way we can push out the excess wheat paste and air pockets that are underneath the poster, and that way the poster will lie flat on the linen backing. If we didn't use the Mylar, it might move the pieces of paper around, and we don't want that. And now, using some clean sponges, we're wiping off the excess wheat paste that's on top of the poster, or whatever wheat paste may have gotten on top of the poster. We need to make sure it's off so that when it dries, there are no nasty streaks of dried wheat paste. I have to be careful the way I move the sponge so that I don't accidentally lift up the pieces of paper. Elving's performances featured many greats of the Yiddish stage, such as Menashe Skolnick, Moshe Oysha, Aaron Lebedoff, and even such name actors as Paul Muni and Molly Picon, who went on to fame on the American stage and in Hollywood.
Okay, the poster is linen backed. There's still tape on the face of the poster, which I'm going to remove after the poster's dry, such as in this spot. And I'm going to deal with that. Here's some more tape here. I'm going to deal with that after the poster's dry, because it's too delicate to take the tape off in its current state. And we've got to let this screen dry, and we've got to go in and restore it. There are letters missing, so we've got to research this.
We'll be right back. Incidentally, I want to remind you that if you want to bring me your posters to have me look at them so that you can have me restore them, you need to set up an appointment. More on that later. Well, the poster has been drying for a few days. There's still tape on the face of it, so I'm taking naphtha and letting the naphtha work its way under the old dried adhesive to loosen it up so that I can remove the tape from the face of the poster. The tape, I would assume, is less than 50 years old, maybe as little as 20 or 30 years old, because the tape seems to be fairly strong and it hasn't yellowed.
Pieces of scotch tape off the poster that were on the poster, and now I'm stuck with wherever there was tape, there is now fading in those areas.
I'm now burnishing the poster with this wooden spatula to push down the creases that are still riding high on the face of the poster to make it as flat as possible before my wife Oki goes in and does the paper fills. The theater building was a brick structure with accommodations for 1,200 to 1,400 people. As you entered the lobby from Montgomery Street, there were two sets of double doors that led into the theater. To the left of the doors was an alcove with a candy stand. The lobby candy stand was run by Louis and Rosie Zlotin. They did a good business during intermissions. They also employed a candy butcher, a preteen from the neighborhood, to hawk candy up and down the aisles between acts. Recollections of a candy butcher. Seymour Pierce, 83, a retired Newark post office employee, recalls working at Elving's as a candy butcher. Quote, "When I was 11 or 12 in the 1930s, I sold candy through the aisles. I was able to watch the performances from the back of the theater." Aaron Elving, son of theater manager Israel Elving, recalled that Bernard Elving was a powerful stage presence in drama and tragedy, equaled only on the American stage by John Barrymore. Before a performance, Bernard Elving would talk into a full-length mirror for 15 to 25 minutes to work himself into the mood of the play before going on stage. Bernard Elving's daughter, Eleanor, used to watch her father perform from the box adjacent to the stage. Sometimes her mother's performance was so powerful that his daughter would dash out of the theater in tears during the performance. The Elving's orchestra consisted of six or seven pieces led by Sam Grossman, who was also the violinist. He held that position during the entire lifetime of Elving's theater. The Grossman Orchestra played not only for the stage shows, but also provided light Yiddish music while the incoming guests were being seated, and at the end of the show while they were departing until the theater was empty. Elving's also had a chorus of six girls who were available for those types of plays that called for their services. Although they sang in Yiddish, only two of the six were actually Jewish.
If you're interested in showing me your vintage posters, you can do it one of two ways, either by email or by coming here in person. If you want to do it by email, send me an email to the address on the screen. Tell me something about your posters. Tell me their size. Tell me their condition. Send me some photos, and I'll be happy to get back to you with a price and recommendations for the restoration. Now, if you want to bring them here in person, I need to send you a security pass, which means you have to set up an appointment with me. And if you're planning to drive here, I can also send you a parking pass. Remember, parking is usually easier on the weekends. It's less busy in the Navy Yard on the weekends. And I'm here pretty much 7 days a week, but by appointment only.
The poster and the paper fills are all dry, so I am trimming it down off the screen so that it is easier to do the coming restoration challenges that await Oki in the touch-up department. She will be touching up the paper fills to make them both match the white paper as well as recreate the Hebrew characters. Israel Elving reached potential audiences before each new show with advertisements in the Jewish Chronicle, an English language weekly published for Newark's Jewish community, and in the Newark edition of the Jewish Daily Forward, printed in Yiddish. But the most effective way Israel Elving targeted Elving's prime audience was with colorful window posters printed at the West Side Printing House and placed in the windows of kosher butcher shops in Newark and in outlying communities in Passaic and Union counties with sizable Jewish populations. Each shopkeeper received two free passes for displaying the poster in his window. A poster like this one.
This is B-E-R-N-A-R-D, Bernard. B-E-R-N-A-R-D.
B-E-R-N-A-R-D. N-A-R-D?
Yeah. I want you to make that. See, some of the paper has overlapped the R, but I want you to try to cheat it so that the name Bernard looks good. In other words, see this line? This line should be straight across. This Elving.
Don't go away. Oki will complete this poster for Elving's Metropolitan Theater. We're back in the Posterfix shop, and Oki continues to touch up the face of this Elving's Metropolitan Theater poster from the 1920s.
You don't have to do that.
You want me to paint all or leave this here?
Paint all. Paint all.
Paint all?
Paint all. Unless you think it'll blend well. Thank you. So you finished this line that says what a woman can do. Nice job on the M. I'm taking one last look at it. By the end of today, it may be finished, so I want to get one last look as to what it looks like before it's finished. I have an image of that that maybe you can use just to make it darker, the union label. Thank you. Nice job. Even remade the Union logo.